Okay, 3, 2, 1, click. Welcome to episode 12 of Lelouch Chronicles. And I see we're back to the usual intro.
Military forces.
Remember, I hate terrorism.
It's literally like 7 or 8 people in total. Military force.
Hey, Teo. Don't remember, Lelouch hates terrorism.
And also, didn't Harry Potter do the same thing? Have a few people. Although at least they were all wizards.
Was that Dumbledore's army or something?
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, usual intro, which kind of reminds me why I just skip Japanese anime intros and just
go. Yes, you don't have to say that every time we watch this intro. This feels like this guy sounds a bit like the vocalist from Field of View.
Field of what?
Field of View. It was a former Japanese pop band who did. They're most famous for making the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Japanese song, the one that you know the Yu-Gi-Oh! Bridge series, the intro that has the Japanese song. That's the one.
Yeah. Okay, maybe it is. I don't really know.
No, I'm pretty sure it isn't because they've disbanded in the early 2000s.
And I'm pretty sure we wouldn't come back on something this stupid.
Well, again, Tio, considering they waste talented voice actors on this show.
In America, but...
America.
Then again, considering the Japanese voice acting department is relatively limited to... I would imagine that even in the original version, there were pretty much known... Okay.
This episode is called...
Whatever.
Potatoes.
It's called an episode.
Is this the meeting of the writers?
You know what thought came to me?
What?
You know one complaint against against the Star Wars prequels is that is all the politics scenes.
Well, this show, at least from what I can tell so far, doesn't have that much political stuff.
Actually, I'd argue the opposite. I don't think the prequels, you know, all the scenes combined, none of the scenes are even that long anyway. Whereas here, there's more of them, and it's much less interesting.
Implying that the scenes in the prequels were interesting.
Yes, there is a little bit of interest in those.
No, there isn't, Whips.
There is already some entertainment.
As much as I would enjoy seeing Star Wars not in a complete action way and more in a seeing what the ordinary citizens, quote unquote, do, I have to agree with Pedro that the prequels do not render justice at all to the politics of the Republic.
Again, those things are pretty.
Is that a giant magnet?
Not to mention this. Star Wars is about force versus good versus evil, not taxation and trade. Anyway, back to this.
Remind me, Dweeves, the Pink Princess is supposed to be an evil person, right?
A bad guy. I don't get. Okay,
okay, unless at the very end she pulls a gun out of her ass and kills a douche, I don't see how.
The dead list.
Okay, I'm going to go to TV Tropes and find out for myself.
Don't spoil us, bro.
I guess if you're with the Britannian government, you're a bad guy.
I guess, but she has different ideas. She told in the episode where she was hanging out with Yuri Lowenthal's character.
And what do you mean by spoilers exactly?
If she kills someone, she dies or something. Yeah.
Wait, really? We're introducing another new character?
Of course.
How many new characters are you going to introduce without developing any of the other ones you already have?
Not just that, Pedro. At least if you wanna introduce new characters, kill some other in order to balance things out and not to have like a trillion characters.
Oh, that's right. I forgot. This bitch is also one of those obsessed with Lelouch.
I did a little bit of digging, and there is a incident. I won't say what it is. It's going to come up. That kind of cements. That pink-haired person is a bad guy.
Alright.
Wait, is it me or has...
Daily reminder...
A little?
Daily reminder that the last school episode that we had was like 10 episodes ago or something.
Hang on. Has Shirley's voice deepened? Did Shirley's voice deepen a little bit there? I mean, I know some girls have deep voices, but really?
I don't even care, honestly.
Drunk or something when recording that line.
I wish I could care, but I'm... This character is so bland that, honestly, at this point, they could have her speak like a man, and that would feel just about as appropriate.
What do you mean? By character being bland, which one?
All of them. Gee, I mean, seriously, every single character in this stupid show is at best two-dimensional, at best, not even three-dimensional.
It's an all-you-can-eat buffet of bland characters. Take your pick.
Yeah.
What's with the random shots? Usually, when you cut to like an exterior shot, you're setting up.
You know what's the thing, by the way?
Shot, but then back to the scene you're already on.
Why can't they draw these girls like they're 18 years old? Because they don't even look 18. They look like they're.
That's standard anime logic, Pedro said.
No, but I've seen animes and entais that do it properly, though.
I know, it depends on the writer, though, Pedro. In that case, it's a 50-50 deal. Roulette.
Look! He's taking her letter, or love letter, or whatever.
I smell hijinks.
Oh, boy.
What?
Maybe now Senpai will finally notice me.
Is this going to be like a comic relief episode or something?
Allow me to remind everyone in the audience that the last time we did this, we had everything about saving a cat, and it didn't turn out very well.
Yeah. I'm just going to say this. Final Fantasy Type Zero does this much, much better in a much funnier way.
Oh, and they just resolved that bit anyway.
Thank God.
So what was the point of that?
Well, padding. Take your
pick. At least it was short. Who's that guy?
What the advisor is?
This is like in Spider-Man 3. Let's introduce subplots just so we can drop them like a few minutes later.
Yeah.
And bring them back when it's convenient.
Yeah. I forgot this. Who voices this character?
Amy Kincaid, and I believe she's actually married to one of the voice actors.
So nepotism.
Again, I'm not quite sure.
Whatever, I don't really care.
Indicate that. Hang on, let me check to be sure.
Oh, hey, Lelouch.
My dad works at Nintendo and told me new exclusive infos.
Yeah, the NX is actually an evil killer robot machine. Well, at least someone's... He's like the only... aside from Shirley, that guy's the only character who's not a mopey sod.
Well, honestly, Dweebs, pretty much the rest of quote-unquote the knights, black knights, of Lelouch are probably the most human characters in the entire show.
Yeah, these are this is the two-dimensional groupie. The rest is the one-dimensional wasteland.
Yeah, Shirley's voice actress, she's married to Liam O'Brien.
As for three-dimensional characters, they're nowhere to be seen.
And Liam O'Brien also was involved in writing the scripts, so...
You know what I'm starting to think, too?
Yes.
Considering considering Megaton Musashi is also going to be an academy drama mixed with super robots. I wonder if Hino saw this and he think, oh my god, this is such
shit. I need to fix this.
I need to somehow make something to bring legitimacy back to this Jara.
I need to save the world.
Is Liam O'Brien jacking off?
I must somehow make sense of our convoluted situation.
Okay, I guess Liam O'Brien was jacking off. I don't...
Is that...
Holy shit, she's ripped
off! What the fuck was that?
Masturbation?
Was she masturbating over files?
You know what, anime? You don't have anything to lose at this point. Just go full hentai on us. At least then you'll have something worthwhile to show.
Have Shirley and C2 make out or something.
Yeah. Let's do that.
You don't even need a reason.
Who cares? Like, it's an hentai. Nobody watches an hentai for story. Well, to be fair, there are... not every hentai is, like,
Plotless.
Believe it or not, Webs, much like in other... this is typical of Japanese culture. Believe it or not, Japanese porn tend to put a lot more effort into the context... Don't get me wrong, it's not like there's like an epic plot or something like that, but...
Well, if you want to search something like that, look no further than the Black Bible series.
Oh, no, the Black Bible, yeah. And honestly, the thing about the Black Bible there is it's mostly just satanic stuff for the sake of context, not so much in terms of story. Sometimes you'll get... there are a couple entities out there who do succeed at giving some basic context that is at the very least competently written. Oh, that's right. I forgot I'm supposed to care about this girl. I have no idea. What's her name again?
She's sister.
There's an entire season dedicated to her point of view.
I think it's a manga series.
I don't even remember her name.
I'm trying to remember, actually.
Well, if I don't remember, you, what chance do you?
Code Geass will return after these messages.
And welcome back.
Okay. Obligatory sister moment. Moving on.
It's like hitting a checklist.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Ever since the last episode, now she's also into him.
Actually, I've done some digging. Also, Word of God says these two are not going to be an item. In fact, they even...
Well, we know that nobody here is going to be an item because Lelouch is a fucking douche. What I mean is the girls being into him, not he being into them.
No. They don't look at each other like that.
Well, I know he doesn't, but she... I mean, the last episode kind of said otherwise.
I don't even know at this point.
Lulu.
I'm late for a very important date. Okay. Pedro, you know when you said... None of these characters really look 18. A couple of them don't even sound 18. I call dibs on...
Whatever.
Oh, hi, Lowenthal's character.
Glug, glug, glug.
So?
And then what?
Alright, I remember, she mind-raped him. Oh, hi, Liam. Please save the day, once again. You know what, Dweebs?
Yeah?
And Pedro, now I pretty much realized, since Liam O'Brien is the one that contributed much to, you know, the story writing.
In English dubs, they only adapt the script, they don't change the story.
No, but my point is, since he saw the script, probably as first, compared to the others, he saw this character, the scientist guy, and said, okay, this guy seems to be the most savage of all of us. I'm going to be voicing this.
Wait, is this character new? I don't even remember if this character has showed up before.
He's assistant.
Purple has been in the show since the start.
Yeah, I don't even remember her.
She's Liam O'Brien's character assistant.
Yeah, okay, that's my gimmick. Hey Pedro, that could be our gimmick. Every time we see a character whose name we don't remember, we'll just think of a nickname for them based off what their distinctive physical attribute is.
Sure, why not?
And now we're in the trailer of Final Fantasy Versus 13.
Noctis Orgy.
Noctis Orgy
is Prince Noctis in Japanese.
Yeah, I know, but it sounds like Noctis Orgy as if they're all going to have sex with Noctis or something.
I know.
I'm the person with stick.
This is my clue stick.
Basically, Webs, in an earlier version of the story, Noctis had a chauffeur. But then that chauffeur was later changed to Ignis.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, now we've got
I think it's the leader of a Japanese resistance.
Right. Are you sure it's a good idea to be bringing him along on missions like this, unless this is your base?
I don't know.
Well, yeah, whatever. I don't care.
That'd be like if you're at war and yet the Prime Minister decided to throw himself into the action every time.
I am so beyond caring. It's not even funny.
Well, Zero did nothing wrong!
Leave Zero alone! Take off his mask. Wait, he can't do that. He hasn't competed in a wrestling match. Don't! You will not see the horrors of...
Tan tan tan! What?
Wait, is that the Dakota Fanning from Twilight New Moon? I don't.
Well, this came out. I think the dub came out in like 2008. I'm not quite sure when they dubbed it. But could you imagine? I can imagine Kate Higgins getting that director saying, "Okay, sound like you're on Twilight."
Tanta plot twist. The real Lelouch was in that mecha.
Yeah.
Also, Lupin the Third music for some reason.
Of course. That makes great, perfect sense. Founder of what?
I think I got it wrong. He's not the leader of Japanese resistance. Or it is.
There's a lot of people getting wrong in this commentary series, isn't
true,
it?
True, but at least it seems that between us, I am the one getting, you know, the most of it.
Well, we never claimed this commentary series to be accurate.
Dun, dun, dun!
Dun!
Well, easily.
I read the script.
Yes. Reminder that Lelouch is supposed to be like the son of the guy with the giant wig.
Yeah, maybe we should have gone into this earlier, no? Oh, okay, never mind. Backstory done. I love how the backstories of every single character is just only slightly brushed upon. It's not as important or anything. guys.
Wow.
I think I got lost. Who's the old guy again?
Old guy.
A giant industrial chief. Now he's basically gonna support Zero's group, since he recognized Lelouch's face.
Meanwhile, they're going around looking at...
Oh no, people died.
Did you see Teo? War is hell.
Yes.
Okay, I guess that we're moving on from that scene. You're already here now?
Right, the date, I just...
Opera scene!
Dies Irae? What?
And now an opera.
It's the Dies Irae. Why?
Because they hate you, I don't know. What? What are you doing, lady?
You're gonna catch pneumonia, girl. She's gonna slap him.
I see that, folks.
Slap him. Go ahead. You know you want to. Go ahead. Do it.
Do it, faggot.
Stop talking. Just slap him.
Then what?
Oops.
Dun.
Wait. Did Lelouch kill our father? Who was our father again?
I don't. I'm lost on this one too. Actually,
I don't. Okay, I'm guessing this is Hold on. If Lelouch did this a couple episodes ago, why is she only reacting now?
She saw a body before, so I guess she had to recognize it.
But then why couldn't we see that happening? This comes a bit out of... Okay, Okay. So...
What?
No, they're just hugging, I think.
No, we're kissing, actually.
I can't tell, it's too far out.
In this episode, we had stuff like hijinks due to a misinterpretation for a letter... Masturbation, mind you, almost graphically, that stupid exchange between the industry chief and the douche, Liam O'Brien still not giving a shit about anyone, and now this. What a fucking mess.
Alright, let me quickly get to check the wiki to see if they did indeed kiss, because I thought there was just a hug, but might as well check, why not. Zero and core members surely Fernand informs him of her father's death indirectly caused by Zero. Alright, it doesn't say whether or not they... I'll have to look it up later. Hold on. Anyway, that episode was stupid and it made no sense. But then again, were you expecting anything else?
Also, Yuri Lowenthal's character was completely pointless in the episode. He was just there to show us we'd recovered from the mind.
I would have said this would be like a Shirley-centered episode, but she's... She isn't in it much. She's only in it, like, most, in terms of, like, the longest she's in a certain part of this is, like, 3 to 4 minutes.
Never mind, Teo, you're right. Shirley does indeed kiss Lelouch.
Got it.
Oh, boy. Well, that's gonna... As if this show wasn't cliche enough, now we've got love.
I don't have a problem with romance as long as it's well done, but this is terrible.
Well, Lelouch is a plank of wood that doesn't give a shit about love.
And Shirley's also a plank of wood. Actually, well, yeah, they kind of deserve each other.
Yeah. Okay, everybody, so in the next episode, maybe Lelouch and Shirley will start dating.
Woo.
See you then.
See ya.
See ya then.